Hey there everyone, thanks for tuning in again, and today I have an older holiday edition piece from General Giant Studios. It is the Commander Cody 2008 Holiday Edition Mini Bust. Back then I wasn't into collecting as much as I was, or as I am now, but 2007 was actually my very first Star Wars celebration, and the year I also picked up my very first General Giant piece, which is the Yoda mini bust, the regular one, not the 3D version from a few years back. And then I didn't get into the PGM or direct buying or actual, you know, full-scale collecting until a few years later. But when I did find out this was the holiday edition piece, I was kicking myself and could not believe that I was getting into the game so late and that I could miss such a wonderful, fun piece such as this. Granted, back in 2007, I was in 7th grade, so I was maybe 12, 13 years old, and maybe didn't have the funds and, you know, knowledge or know-how to actually collect, but luckily I came around someone who was willing to trade, so I did trade a Master Replica's lightsaber, which had just been kind of sitting around and was kind of taking up space. And it was Yoda's lightsaber, so wasn't too much of an impact, but, you know, it did affect me also for the trade, because that was, you know, one of my favorite pieces. But of course I would rather have a mini bust like this, and I figure I'm never gonna find one again or one at a decent price. So here we go, here's the review for it, about 6 years later after it's, or 7 years after its release, and let's jump right into this review. So as you can tell, it is Commander Cody from Episode 3, and instead of holding the hologram of Darth Sidious when he's announcing Order 66, which I do believe General Giant has that mini bust as well, they have replaced it with a crystal snowman, or a glass snowman. And now the really cool part is that it lights up as well. On the bottom here, there's a little button you just press, and as you can see, the blue light shining through the hand. I will turn off the light so you can get a better look at that, but let me get a close-up of it now in the daylight. Even now, it gives it a really cool effect. Sometimes these lights, especially being through a glass piece like this, it might be really hard or just not even worth it to turn on the light, but I think it's really cool. You know, they did a great job of sculpting and designing it so that even in daylight and, you know, kitchen lighting as I'm in now, it looks really good. So let me turn that off, and I'll turn it back on again when the lights are off. So other than that, the other difference is the scarf, which is a cloth blue scarf. I'll take the head off so you can see it. And, you know, just something simple. It's actually wrapped around this rubber or another plastic piece. So, you know, pretty simple, but just really cool addition, and, you know, gives it that really holiday spirit. And if, you know, anyone knows me, they know I'm a big sucker for holiday edition anything, whether it be the comics or collectibles. I have all the Star Wars holiday edition action figure sets too, the one that has like Yoda with the Santa suit on, or the Jawas with the gifts, and C-3PO and R2 and all that. And I was just so happy to finally get this piece as well. Taking a closer look as well, you can see it is Commander Cody from Episode 3. They did a phenomenal job capturing all the battle marks and scars on the armor, on the helmet as well. The orange just looks perfect, because that's an issue that some action figures or some items do have with Commander Cody. They don't get the right orange or the right yellow, I guess. Sometimes they're just way too yellow or they're too dark, but this one is damn near perfect to what Commander Cody actually looks like in the film. And capturing, you know, his visor as well. This is my favorite phase of the clones and clone Commander Cody. The utility belt down there, the stripes, and as you can see, more battle marks and damage. And you can even see it in the white. I'll get a close-up of that as well. Let me see if I can capture that in. There we go. You can see more black marks in the white part of the armor, and then all the paint basically getting shot off and marked up. Giving a view from the side, his other arm kind of resting in that position. Now, I do have to say, the person that did send me this didn't do a great job with packaging it. I'll give an overview of the package as well. But essentially, if anyone collects General Giant, you'll know the boxes are, you know, they can essentially be shipped how they are. But my person did that, and there's a little antenna that's supposed to go right here that broke off. You know, it's just such a small piece, and I'm not surprised it did, especially that he didn't ship it in a shipping box and he just shipped it in the General Giant box. So I'm really bummed at that, but you know, it's kind of like, at least I have the figure, or at least I have the piece here, and it's nothing too major, but it's something that'll be in the back of my head and something that now all my viewers will now know about. Luckily, there isn't any other major damage, and I don't have any plans to sell or trade this piece, so I'm fine with it. You know, it's nothing to skulk about every day and worry about. I'm just very happy to finally have this piece and, you know, add it to my collection, my growing collection at that. So I'll give a turnaround to the back. You can see his light backpack and the utility belt as well, the back of the helmet with his antennas. Turning around as well, you can see the other arm has the, not quite sure what this is, I guess another holster for something. The other arm doesn't have it over here. And then again, holding the snowman. And I'll give a close-up on the helmet as well. It's a little bit hard to see the helmet as they do have him facing down, so he's looking at the snowman. And then you can turn it any which way, if I can find that again. So you know, you can turn it side to side, but it's best to keep him looking at that. And then here's a close-up. Just a phenomenal job, General Giant. I mean, I am always happy, and even thinking that way back in 2008, they were, even from actually the beginning, General Giant has always done a great job. But even comparing it to today's pieces, and this is still just amazing quality that is still improving, and I'm just, you know, blown away by the detail and the accuracy to the films. You know, there's some things you don't just capture in the films or even looking at pictures, and General Giant is able to bring that to your shelves and your collections. And there's the little slot for the peg right there. And then this is also the 132 out of 1500. So it was, you know, a pretty large run. And then let me give the, so this is the packaging which all the holiday edition figures do come in. I know I was just watching Yoda's news review of the 2014 gold Stormtrooper, and it was also a white box, so just a very simple General Giant logo. And as you can see, you know, the pretty shoddy job at shipping at that. So, you know, nothing too much to talk about there. And then the box at the bottom. And let me see if I can get the certificate of authenticity as well, so you know all their pieces do come with this little pack. Let me get that out just to show you all. So as you can see, this has some holiday flair too, the mistletoes or leaves, not sure what those are called. Again, 132 out of 1500, and a picture of Cody. So let me go ahead and turn off the lights real quick. Boom, boom, boom. Boom. I might have to close the blinds as well, but let's see how this looks. Ah, there we go. So even the camera doesn't seem to be picking it up too much, but in person it is a hell of a lot brighter, even with the outdoor light coming in. But you know, it's just, let me try to get a little shadow. There we go. Now it looks good. So you can see it nicely reflecting off on Cody as well. So I can just get that turned to him. There we go. So, you know, just a phenomenal, phenomenal piece. I'm very happy to finally be having this. Huge thank you to General Giant for producing this and giving collectors and fans like myself something to add to their collection and something to just enjoy every time we take a look at our collections. Thank you all for watching too. Thank you for the support. Stay tuned for the next video and we'll see you next time.